headspace shell. Headspace space shell. So apart from lab manual, I'll be using different names so that that would be better understandable for you. Instead of R1, C1, T1, I'll be using general names. So to see whether what are the list of tables present, we type LIST. So what if this is empty list, you don't have any tables right now. To see the version, you just type version. What in which version you are running. To create a table, create space. I am creating a table name stores with one column for family name Amazon. So the first parameter would be the table name and the second parameter would be the column family name. So for now, for this table, I have created only one column family name. So let's see the description of it. If we type describe stores, so name of the column family, what name of the table and name of the column family and other configuration details. For example, versions, default it is set to 3 and you could change versions of each column family name and other configuration details also you could alter. So for example, let me alter the versions of this column family Amazon example. So we use alter space stores . So what you want to change, you need to give that name. So that is Amazon and I want to change versions. I'm setting that to 5. I have 3 here. I'm setting that to 5. This gives me error as because that this is in use, the table is in use. So first we need to disable the table. Any structure related changes, you need to disable the table, then you could make any changes to the structure. For example, if I want to change any column name, or if I want to add any column name or column family or anything configuration details, so you need to disable the table first. Now you could make any changes to the structure of the table. So if we want to use that table again, we need to enable that. So let's see what is the description of the stores. That should be 5 because we have set versions to the 5 of this column family Amazon. So if you see, the versions is set to 5 of column family name Amazon. So for now, I have only one column family name. For example, I have more stores to add. So I need to alter it again. I cannot alter it directly. I need to disable the table again because it is something related to structure change. So I'm adding another column family for the table stores, let's say Best Buy, and I want to add more, less, let's Walmart. Now let's see what would be in this question. So if you see, there is Amazon and again Best Buy and Walmart. To check, if I forgot, what is that, enabled or not, or disabled or not? I could check by using is disabled. I need to give table name. I'm asking whether it is disabled or not. So it gives me true, it is disabled. So we can't use this table again. So we need to enable that. So whether it is enabled or not, we could check by using is enabled also. It says false, so it is not enabled. So you couldn't use the table. So we need to enable that first. So we use enable space the table name. Now it is enabled. For example, if I want to see what are all the rows present in the table, I use scan. So there are no rows inserted, no data is inserted in this table yet. So if I want to insert, we will use put. For example, I want to insert into the Amazon column for a family name, a product with a camera. Sorry, you need to specify table name first. Then row, what is the row that you want to insert, and in which column family you want to insert. And if I want different departments, for example in electronics section or clothing section, so I could specify I need to give a value. For example, this is table name, this is row name, and this is column family name with some extra information that I'm giving. And what is the value? For example, if I want to store the price of the camera, so just say 550. So let's see whether it got inserted or not. The row name is camera, and of column family Amazon electronics, and you will have timestamp that would be generated by default by the system itself, and the value that I am assuming that I just want to store is 550. I just want to store the price of it. If I just want to give you a clear picture, we have created column family name Amazon and column family name Best Buy. And column family name Walmart. Have inserted a row named camera in Amazon's electronic we have stored it value of 550. In the same way, I could store for Best Buy as well. instead of Amazon, I give column family name Best Buy. With some different, let's say 600. And if you scan the stores again, you'll be able to see what are the rows present. It's the same row camera, but in the Best Buy we have stored the value 600 with electronics again. This is another column family name, and this is another column family name. And this is the value, and this is the row that we are storing. For example, instead of camera, if I want to store AirPods with value, let's say 100. If I scan it again, you'll be able to see AirPods here. In which column family? Best Buy Electronics. So there could be a row named AirPods which is related to only Best Buy. We have given value 100. So if it is a traditional relational database, this also, a space gets created. For this also we need to store it as null, which occupies memory. But in HBase, this column family doesn't have any value, so it doesn't consider it as a space. So no storage space is wasted in HBase. For example, in Amazon section itself, I have clothing section. In Best Buy, I don't have any clothing section. Let's say the product is a t-shirt. Let's say $15. So if I scan it again, it gives me what is the row, and this is a in Amazon only I have created a clothing section. So Amazon column family name, but it's a different department. I could consider it as a different department. Electronics is different department for Amazon, and the clothing is also a different department for Amazon. I have taken this kind of example so that would be better understandable. I mean, if it is A1 or C1, T1, you get confused. So I'm just taking the real-time example. For example, I just want to change this value, AirPods value, to 150. I could directly use put and the table name and row name. In Best Buy I have, which is electronics section. I just want to change it to 150. So if I scan it, the value would be 150. It gives me the most recent value. So if I want to see all the versions of it, I mean, before, if I have made any changes, if I want to see that as well, I could specify how many number of versions I just want to see. So it shows me the previous value also and the present value also, if I have made another change again. Let's suppose 200. specify to, it gives me most recent two values because I have specified version as 2. Only 2 I have mentioned. If I mention it as 3, it gives me all the versions. And maximum is 3 as we have seen in description. We have changed the version for Amazon but not for Best Buy. So the maximum that we could store the number of versions is 3. And if I want to delete a row, I need to specify store name, table name first, then row name, and from which column family I want to delete it. Let's say I just want to delete it from Best Buy. So it gets deleted. Let's scan and see. So I have deleted camera which is in Best Buy. Well, I'm not able to see now. Let's say I want to insert a value of camera in Walmart column family in electronics section with value with camera with different column family names. So if I want to get a particular row, we will use get and table name, then row name. So in these two column family names, you have that particular row. If I want to I have 2 rows in Amazon column family, so just let me try delete all from table name with column family . The column family is taken as Amazon Electronics. Okay, let me create another. In Amazon Electronics column family, I'm storing another value. So in Amazon Electronics, I have 2 products, AirPods and camera for now. So if I want to delete what whatever are there in this particular column family, I could use delete all. Sorry, I need to mention the row name, not the column family name, to delete. Yes, so whatever the rows related to camera got deleted. If I want to delete a particular row which is in any column family name, I could use delete all. If I want to delete only one column, one row, I could use delete table name. Row name, and I need to mention column family. I have only one table name, name stores. If I scan it, yeah, we have tried deleting AirPods from Amazon electronics column family. These are different configurations that you could make changes by using alter. For example, if I want to change the in-memory value or versions value or any kind of value, you could use alter. If I want to get If I want to get a row, I could use get. In whichever column family is there, that gets displayed. Yeah, if we want to see what are the filters present, we could just type show filters. These are all different filters that are present in HBase that we could use. If the if I want to check whether a table name exists or not, for example, it says the table stores does exist because we have created just now. Let me check with another name. We have not created a table name with HBase table, so it shows me it doesn't exist. If we want to check the status, we could just simply type status. And if we want to check in detailed format without space, you need to type status, then detailed. It gives only details. Many number of files, and if you want something in detailed format, you could use detail, but you shouldn't give space here. Have only one table for now. If I want the same table to drop it and recreate it, I could use truncate. Scan. We don't have anything because it has dropped the table, and here it has recreated it, which is a new one. We don't have any content in that. For example, if we have a table named HBase table with column family 1, and if column family 2, column family 3. I'm just mentioning only 3 column families for now. If I want to add more column families, I could add through using alt. If I list it, I have HBase table also.
Thank you.
drop all the tables that I have. I could drop all the tables at a time. And I first, before dropping these two tables, I need to disable it. So if we have more than two or three or n number of tables, we could use disable all. And I want to disable all the tables. Let's check, is that disabled or not? To disable all the tables, we use disable all, but it's not working for me right now. I don't want to use disable all, I need to mention not only start with dot, dot star, so that it disables all the tables. I have only two tables for now. If I check, is that disabled or not? It gives me true, it is disabled. If I want to drop all the tables, so as I want to drop all the tables, I need to disable them, or else I will not able to drop them. I have only two tables, so I'm dropping them. So if I list whatever the tables that I have, it is empty. So I have tried maximum to cover all the commands. So if you have any doubts, please drop me an email so that I could.